On today's Maker's Mashup, we're doing motion tracking with an ESP32-CAM. Welcome back, Makers. I wanted to do an animatronic project for Halloween where I was tracking motion left and right as someone walked across in front of my yard. Now, the difficulty I had was using these PIR sensors or maybe these ultrasonic motion sensors. These devices really don't have a very good range when you look at something as large as your yard. And I ran some initial tests indoors, and these worked really great, but my experience outdoors was less than consistent. Now, I've used these ESP32-CAMs before. It's a great little microcontroller if you've never used one that has an onboard camera, it's got Wi-Fi, it's got Bluetooth, 240 megahertz processor, it's even got an SD card slot on it. And while the camera itself is really nothing spectacular, it does work really well for low cost maker projects, and they'll only run you about $10. I've used them for network-based webcams before for Octoprint, and I've got a card at the top that will get you to that video if you want to see another project that uses these ESP32-CAMs. Now, with the ES32-CAM, we've had motion detection on it for some time. And what I wanted to do was more than just simple detection. I wanted to be able to track motion across the field of view. And then I wanted to turn an animatronic character left or right where the person or object that was detected in the field of view was. So today we're going to be working on using this ESP32-CAM, some inexpensive toy stepper motors, to track a person across that field of view. And this project is simple to assemble, and as always, it's open source, so you can modify the models or the source code to fit your projects. So with all that said, let's get to work. Eloquent Arduino gave me the groundwork for this project. Modifying their code, I was able to take a camera frame and squish the data down to an array of detection points. So anything that was on the vertical axis became a value in the horizontal array. From there, I broke down the values into 10 degree segments, which are assigned a value based on the amount of movement from one frame to the next. This indicates where the most activity or motion exists in the field of view. Then we move the stepper to that location. This sounds really complex, but the source code is small given the number of operations taking place. I want to also give a shout out to Reader Al in our Discord, who helped me noodle out some of the math to make all this happen. If you're not a member of our channel Discord, you can find links for that in the description. It's absolutely free and a great resource for any maker project you're working on. So now that I had a working sensor, I had to build an enclosure for the ESP32-CAM and hook up some steppers. Installing the ESP32 is a piece of cake. All we have to do is press it into the 3D print. Now we'll need to install the electronics into the stepper enclosure. We've got one stepper driver, the USB power connection, DuPont terminal block. This allows us to easily connect everything without soldering. Now we're going to install the stepper driver. All that's necessary is running two leads from the positive and negative on the driver to the terminal block, positive and negative. Now we're going to run our input power from the USB to the terminal block. Now we'll install our wiring that goes to the ESP32. We'll need to hook up the positive and negative to the terminal block, and then the four other wires to the stepper driver, which will connect back to our ESP32. Be sure to remember the order that you have these wired in. They'll have to go in the same order on the ESP32 with the exception of swapping the last two around, and that's due to the pinouts on the ESP32 itself. Now we're going to feed in our stepper driver wire and attach it to the stepper driver. Now we need to hook up our USB power. Now that our wiring's complete, we're going to attach the lid and secure it with an M3 screw. Now we'll feed the wires running to the stepper through this 3D print, which will hold the ESP32. I tied a knot in the signal cable to make sure that it doesn't pull back through the 3D printed part and disconnect from the ESP32. This is pretty simple. We'll start with the power pin and the ground. Then we'll lay these out in the exact same order that we did on the stepper, with the exception of switching the last two. In my case, it was the green and the purple. Now that our wiring is complete, we'll insert this into the 3D printed part and secure it with some M3 screws. The stepper mount just pops on top and then is secured with some M3 screws. Now we'll install the top plate. Here we have our assembled project, and this enclosure over here holds the ESP32 cam. The stepper is in this base here, and the rest of the electronics are right here. Now, I want to illustrate how this works. So what's happening right now is that we have the camera looking at the entire field of view. And if I move my hand here to just catch the edge of the detection range, you'll see here that the skull points over to that direction. And if I just catch the edge of the detection range over here, it will turn its head over to this side over here. Now, if we wanted to have something that's maybe moving in the middle, and I catch that right here, you could see the head is going to then turn to the middle. And now that we've got all this working, let's go give this a try out in my yard. Now, I used an inflatable for this, and I used some magnets and some monofilament line on the top, and then some magnets and the plastic plate on the bottom to hold everything in place. But as you can see, when someone walks in front of the camera, the eye tracks their movement. Now, many of you may be thinking, Rob, this project won't work at night. Well, I do have a fix for that. What I've got here is an IR illuminator or an infrared floodlight, and these run about $30. They will flood an entire area with infrared light that the camera is then able to pick up. Security cameras have used this, but it allows you to work on this project and then be able to use it at night. Now, overall, this project was really easy to put together and honestly something you could probably knock out in a weekend. The ESP32, in my opinion, this project makes it a great alternative to other motion sensors. And the small size really allows you to put this in just about any location. And with just a little bit more code, you could, instead of just detecting motion, either take a picture and upload that to a server, or you could use the onboard SD card to store everything. Now, previously when I've used these, I had to buy a separate programmer, but now they're including these shields that allow you to just snap into place and then program with a regular USB cable, and it just makes the entire process that much simpler. So with that is going to bring the end of today's video. If you liked it, make sure you mash that like button and don't forget to share and subscribe so you don't miss any of my upcoming videos. Now, if you would like to help support the channel, consider checking out my Patreon page or purchasing any of your parts from the links down in the description below, all of which helps support the channel to produce future videos. So with that, I want to say thanks again for watching. We'll see you next time.
Mm-hmm.